I'm going to go backward in time on my Twitter stream so you can see as of 10 minutes ago, which was almost 9:45 on October 1st, 2011, the Brooklyn Bridge protest is documented on everyone's Twitter stream. So you can see that people are retweeting the information how they feel about the subject. And I do think that we are all part of American history this day. Somebody said that we have the power of choice in our pocketbook. And here's a link. So the other thing that you can do is you can link. You can see that here. And that will open a page, a new page, telling you information about the event, about what is the Declaration of the Occupation of New York City. It was also noted that Obama didn't say anything during this day. And one of the big events was that trending topics automatically come up, you would think, based on how many people are tweeting something and how popular an event is. However, the hashtag Occupy Wall Street did not show up in the trends. What showed up was BK, Brooklyn Bridge. So this was quite unusual. And when you go to BK, Brooklyn Bridge, you see a lot about some kind of restaurants, short order restaurants, and not really the protest. And people were asking that question. And then we have all about what was happening live on the street, about the police confronting the people, how the people were arm in arm. I'm just retweeting what people say here. Senator Sanders was saying that they want to demand that Wall Street invest in job creating, productive economy, and stop their gambling. To the audios from Democracy Now, you can hear what's going on, and the people just wanted to get off the bridge. There was also a link to a photograph from the sky of the scene with all the people, and someone was asking whether this was an actual photograph. There was a lot of chanting. And then, of course, at one point, the live feed went down. We're not exactly sure why the live feed went down. Maybe they did not want to show what was going on anymore. And then you have the feeling of all of us together watching what's happening. And you can see that I'm just retweeting, I'm reporting. I really wasn't there in Brooklyn. I'm in a different state, and this other people around the country were watching and chiming in also. Here's when they cut off the live feed. And the big question is, why is Occupy Wall Street, which is the hashtag that is being used to get the information out and let people see it, why wasn't it trending? And that's one I'm just going to click right there. When you click on your hashtag, that color in red that's highlighted, when you click on it, you're going to go to the results of that people talking about that bit of information. And here it says, this is from 7 hours ago. Of course, there's some people who think on the other side that the people should have been arrested. But, you know, I think because the people were blocked from just crossing the bridge, that's what caused the problem. If they were allowed to just walk from one side of the bridge to the other side of the bridge, I think it would have been over and it wouldn't have been a problem. But that's only my opinion. And then here's the question that everybody's wondering. Why are we being censored? Who is manipulating the media, including Twitter, that Occupy Wall Street did not come up as a trending topic. And then here we have the Marines are coming to protect the protesters. And this must be, see a bit.ly image. We will see what that is. This is about Occupy Wall Street. The Marines are coming to protect the protesters. This is reported in from Tampa. The Occupy Wall Street movement may have just received an unexpected surprise. United States Army and Marine troops are reportedly on their way to various protest locations to support the movement and protect the protesters. You have to realize that this is happening in more than just Brooklyn. It's splintered off into many other locations around the country. So it says they're going, I want to send the following message to Wall Street and Congress. I didn't fight for Wall Street. I fought for America. Now it's Congress's turn. Something about what should people demand? Three concrete demands to hold Wall Street accountable. Camped out on Wall Street have been criticized. Okay, here's the demands. Cancel the debts. The crisis we face is fundamentally about a giant pool of bad mortgage debt. We need to work through these debts for recovery to really take off. The only question is who will absorb them, the creditors who made the loans or the people on the other side. In this case, there is no way to share these losses, and the government has stood behind the owners of many of these debts as being too big to fail. The second one is investigate Wall Street. In the build-up to the crisis, bad loans that could never be paid back were passed out to unsuspecting homeowners. These loans were then passed along a chain until they got to investors who thought the loans were made with the utmost diligence. When the entire house of cards collapsed, homeowners were left with bad loans. Investors looked to cover their investments, and a mind-boggling 5 million people were foreclosed on. Loans were made so fast that proper records weren't kept, which means it's difficult to hold creditors and debtors accountable. And you can read more about that. Then the last one is create a financial transaction tax. It is hard to think of something with such a boring name as a particularly radical solution, but an FTT would be an important first step toward remaking our economy so it is not so dependent on the financial sector. Thanks to a wave of deregulation laws in the late 70s and early 80s, finance has been one of the fastest growing sectors over the past 30 years. It's become so important, in fact, that some argue the economy should be run in accordance with the ideas and goals of the financial sector. This way of viewing our economy is less about long-term value than short-term price manipulation, less about investing in communities and peoples than about gaming, tax codes, and regulation, and less about markets as a means of expression, and more about consolidated, cornered market power. A financial transaction tax would help fight back against this and begin to steer our economy toward more sustainable and workable ends. That's very interesting. I'd like to learn more about what that means. And now we're going to go back to, okay, you can see that Veg Press was there, and she is calling it a revolution, and it is now the time to be heard. And you can see she's using a completely different, she's using the BK Bridge, which I think was the one that went trend, that did trend on Twitter today. So you can look there and see what's going on. And you can see that there are many videos. This one's on the Daily Gotham.